Praise the Lord, that's gonna be hard to follow all of that, if you start. The midnight cry leads you closer to the time's running short. In this old world, time is running short, I believe. But I do love to say that I enjoyed last night. Had a good time of fellowship.
Amen.
We got the moon, year, world. Different things done, but God created it all. And
amen.
Y'all remember when he let down the sheep with all the different animals there? That one Jacob there. And he said, no. Uh-uh. He said, what I have created is clean. Mm-hmm. Eat, he said. Sure. Clean and eat. So we clean and we eat. Praise God. Enjoy it. And still enjoying it this morning. I tell you what, me and Bill walked back there a while ago and there's still some smell back there. So, those of you that wasn't here last night, if you want to get filled up on the smell, man, you're welcome to it. That's all you're going to get back there. You just get filled up on the smell. Praise the Lord. You got your Bibles this morning, turn over to the book of St. Luke, chapter 10. Y'all all heard this, been preached on. But this is my first time, I believe, if any, I ain't nothing marked in this Bible. This is my wife's Bible. No, this is Joseph's. So I use hers and his and mine. Maybe I just get in one and stick with it a little while and I switch over. But this one's Joseph. But anyhow, in chapter 10 here, I'm going to read a few verses here. It says, after these things, the Lord appointed other servants also, and sent them two by two. 70, ain't that right? I don't know. 70. And sent them two by two before his face into every city and place where he himself would come. Therefore said he unto them, harvest truly is great, but the laborers are few. Pray ye therefore the Lord of the harvest, that he will send forth laborers unto his harvest. Go your way, behold, I send you forth as lamb among wolves. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Father, we appreciate you this morning, and we love you so much. Praise God. God, thank you for this lovely day, and thank you for this opportunity, God, to bow before you and to give you thanks, God. We thank you again, God, for the fellowship. We thank you, precious Lord. We thank you for each one that's here this morning, God. We come out to hear your words, precious Lord. They hunger for your words, God. And Father, I know this morning that you have a message for us, precious God. And Father, I'm just asking you to use me this morning. I'm your servant, God. You know that I don't have all the words, but I know you do, precious God. Father, so here I am. Just use me the way you see fit, God. Father knows it's on our prayer list this morning. You know the needs there. And we ask you to meet those needs too, Father, according to your will. I love you, precious Lord. Be with our Sunday school teachers, Lord. In Jesus' precious name, Father. Amen.
Amen.
This morning here we see in this, it's detailed about how that Jesus is sending some more disciples out. Brother Bill, when God calls us, he starts sending us doing little things, you know. He appoints things for us. And here, he was sending them two by two, going out ahead of him, sort of like John the Baptist to come in before Jesus, you know, and preach and preparing the way for Jesus. So I reckon that's what you could say here, these disciples was going through this city, or Jesus was later coming, and different cities preparing them to meet Jesus, and they was preaching the gospel, and down in there it tells you that Jesus has gave them all kind of power to do all kind of miracles as they went through the city. And he gave them instructions what to do. And he, even in him, he told them not to even take a purse or no notebook, nothing. He said, because he is going to furnish it when you get there. And if you go into a house in there, he tells you, if they won't receive you in there, just leave, you know. When you go down the road, just shake the dust off your feet there and let it be. But he said, you're going out into the world as lambs, and you're going to be meeting wolves out there. Brothers and sisters, they ain't nothing changed today. The world is full of wolves out there today. And if you don't watch it, they will attack you. Amen. They will get you down. They will corner you. It'll be more than one. And they'll take advantage of you. Brothers and sisters, today, we've got to be like the wolf. That like the lamb that Jesus has sent. Everywhere we go into there, we'll accept, and Jesus will send us the way that we need to go. Brothers and sisters, today, I ain't here today because Harry wanted to be here. I'm here today because Jesus sent me here today. He prepared a way for me, Brother Bill. He prepared a way for me to be here. Different things happen in life. Different things happen. But as Brother Bill said a while ago, one door has been closed and another has been opened. You can go into those doors that Jesus opened today, and you can make progress. Amen? When Jesus is in charge of it. Anyhow, he has sent these out to go out into the world out there. Brothers and sisters, today, before we can go out into the world, we've got to make sure ourselves is cleaned up and be ready to go out into the world. If you don't, the first thing you run across this one here, you'll either show up there, and then you'll take a little bit of this right here, or a little bit of that, and you're right back where you started from. You got to clean yourself up, other words, before you can go out into the world. And that's what Jesus does. That's what Jesus done to these men, their disciples. He cleaned them up before he pushed them out into the world. Because, and he said, I give you power as you go out into the world to overcome the temptations of the devil, to cast out devil, to heal the sick. And we can't do it unless we have the power of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
We got to have that power. Good to see you, Brother Glenn. I didn't know you slipped in on me. I'm sorry I didn't go there. But we've got to have power today to overcome the temptations of the devil. That's the reason Jesus said, get yourselves cleaned up. Get ready. Y'all remember back over earlier, there were the disciples was out, and they was praying for this man's son. But he couldn't cast out the devil. And Jesus was coming into town, and this man was there. And he was begging for Jesus to help him. And Jesus just stopped, and the crowd stopped. And he said, sir, what would you have me to do for you? He said, I want you to heal my son. Said he falls in the fire. He's done. Said, I came into you, disciples, and they couldn't do it. Said, I'm bringing it to you. That fella had enough faith in Jesus Christ that he was going to bring it to him. He loved his son just like we love our children today, and we want to see the best for them. He knows if he can get him to Jesus Christ, that he would heal him. He said, your disciples can't do it. So what do you do? The disciples, Jesus told them, can it come by only by faith? So the first thing that you got to do, you got the first thing that you got to do in your life is get the life of faith and trust. this world. I can't do nothing, Brother Rudy, today without Jesus Christ. He's the one that used the mop and the bucket on me where I was down in sin. But when I come and bowed before the cross, God washed away my sins. He came to my and he mopped it and cleaned me up. Brothers and sisters, let me tell you what. We can't do nothing without the heart being cleaned up.
That's right.
They told the story of a fellow in a mental hospital. How they come up with this plan. Brother Bill said, well, turn the water faucet on here in the sink. And said, we're going to let it overrun. Pour it out on the floor. And said, we're going to give a mop and a bucket to the man that's coming up to get out. And we're going to see what he does. And said, if he turns the water off, he's ready to go out into the world. But said, if he starts mopping, he's got to have some more treatment. So that was the thing. So they done it. And here they brought it in here. The water's running. And he's a mopping, Sister Dolly. He's cleaning it up. He's mopping. But he ain't making no progress. He's steady mopping. He's moving. He's getting the water. He's putting the water in there. But he ain't going nowhere. Why? He ain't going nowhere. Why? Did y'all hear that? He didn't turn the water off. The first thing that we gotta do is, before we go out into the world, is to clean ourselves up and find where the problem's at.
That's right.
If we got a dirty heart, brothers and sisters, today, I can't go and tell Brother Johnny how to live. I can't do it. But if I got a clean heart, Lord will lead me, old boy, and he'll give me the words to tell Brother Johnny. It won't drive him away from the Lord, but lead him to the Lord.
That's right.
And you know, that's what we're doing, Brother Bill. I'm just a disciple. I'm just a servant of God. And he called him out. I'm just sowing the seed. Sort of like farming. We talked a little bit about that up night last night. But when a farmer gets this time of the year, he's getting ready to sow some seed. But first, the ground's got to be plowed and taken care of. And then when you get that ready to go, Brother Rudy, you can plant your seed. But we ain't through then, are we? It's got to be worked. So I work on mine all the time. That's the reason I encourage y'all. Read your word. Study the word. And let the word work on you. Amen.
Amen.
I thought I had a message there the other day. Oh, boy, this is it. And then Friday evening, I went to the deer stand, Brother Bill. And I just felt that message was just useless. That is gone. I raised it out. And the Lord gave me this one. You talking about a man that was happy. You get off down there in the woods where there ain't nobody but you and the Lord.
Amen.
And see what happens. There's changes that is made. The presence of God is so great.
Hallelujah.
And when the presence of God's there, he reveals these things to you, Brother Bill. And here I am sitting there studying. I said, what a wonderful message, God. But I can't do it myself. I keep saying that. There's too many people today, like those disciples. They wanted to do things their own way. But until we turn it all over to Jesus and accept him, and it is Jesus that is working these miracles, it's not him. We've got to get ourselves mopped up.
Amen. and ready to go. Because Jesus is the one that is preparing the way every day in how I wake up. What a beautiful sun. Y'all see the sun coming up this morning?
Amen.
Oh, beautiful. I said, Lord, look, you know what a day you done made. Ain't it pretty? You know, it was pretty before the world was created because that's how far he is ahead of us. And yet, and here we are. We are nothing but his servants to use as he sees best. So let me tell you this. When he called me, I told Sister Carolyn, the young pastor, this morning. I said, I remember when I sat in Buffington Church and people talked about me because, oh boy, 30 years ago, Brother Bill, they'd give out parts in Sunday school and I'd want one so bad. Then I'd take it and I might say two or three words and that'd be it. Some of them would say, well, you ain't gonna do no better than that, I'd just quit. I wouldn't even take a part in it. Yeah, I've been hurt. But let me tell you one thing. Jesus Christ was hurt too.
Amen.
Jesus was hurt. These people there, he sent them out. And they come back telling Jesus, oh, what is happening? And they won't receive you, Jesus, like they ought to. Jesus, they won't believe you that you're coming. What did he tell them on down in there? He said it would be worse for them than it would be for Sodom and Gomorrah.
Amen. Amen.
Jesus stood up and he told them, he said, let me tell you one thing. He said if Sodom and Gomorrah had heard these words back yonder, they would have repented and sat in sackcloth and ashes. But you will not have that. Brothers and sisters, today, every time we preach God's words, somebody might not receive it, but we sow in the words, Jesus is the reaper.
Amen.
I sow the words. Brother Bill may come along and gather the crop.
Amen.
Or I may sow it, and you gather the crop. Or you may sow it, and not you. But the chief priest to Jesus Christ.
Amen. Amen.
So we got to turn everything over to him and let him be the one. And he tells you on down there a little bit further. He said, come into me. My yoke is easy. I'll give you rest. What is that rest? What is that rest? That rest is having peace with Jesus.
Amen.
Having peace with Jesus. That knowing that Brother Bill, everything is all right. All my sins have vanished away. And Jesus is the one who's leading the way. Amen?
Amen.
So you know, before we jump up and say we're going to do this and do that, let's clean ourselves up. Then we can take this mop and bucket, Brother Bill. And we can go out into the world and use what Jesus did give us. The shield of faith, the helm of suffering. All of that Jesus has given us to protect us while we're out
there. Yes.
We take that with us. We clean up this world.
Amen.
One man can't do it himself. Jesus couldn't do it himself. But his heart's desire is that everyone comes to know him as their Savior.
Amen.
And that's my desire. You know what's better for me? It brings me more joy than anything. And that's to see someone come to know Jesus.
Yes.
Amen.
That's what I live for. Every day that I come, I want the Lord to use me in a way. Bring me glory. Do you love him this morning?
Amen.
Amen.
You appreciate him?
Amen.
You know him as your personal Savior?
Amen.
If you do, you're on the right path. If you don't, I urge you to invite him to come today and be your Lord and Savior. It ain't no big draw about that. The man at the cross, he said, Lord, remember me when you get to heaven. Jesus just turned to him. He said, today, you'll be with me in paradise. See how simple that is? I love it.